If you haven't watched season 3 of Heartstopper, please go watch it before watching this video because this video has spoilers. I just got finished watching the show, and the show season 3 is amazing. Heartstopper is one of my favorite shows on Netflix. Let's just start there. Heartstopper has always been a great escape for me. I wish things could be as simple as, you know, having a supportive boyfriend and friends and family. I try not to cry like a baby in some scenes. It's just so crazy. The first thing I would like to talk about is I like how they really talked about the eating disorder issue with Charlie. He actually had enough strength enough to actually come to Nick about the issue, and Nick was being a very supportive boyfriend for him to help him out with his, you know, his issue with eating, the eating disorder. So amazing. I have 3 favorite parts that I liked in the, like, funny parts in the story. I couldn't just choose one. The first one of my favorite parts of this season, when Mr. IJ and when Mr. Farouk were flirting and Charlie walked in on them and Charlie automatically knew what it was. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm glad they actually showed their relationship this time, this season, because I actually stand it in season 2 because they were really cute. Another funny part of this season is when Charlie and Nick were about to get it in, yeah, and the Nick's brother came walked in on them, and then Charlie was like, "I'm just glad it wasn't your mother, girl, cause yeah, oh my gosh." And another funny part is when they went back to school after the summer, and Tyle kept showing Isaac and Charlie L when she started the new art school. Oh look. Basically, Isaac was very sick of Tom. It was so funny. It was just so funny. Oh look. I also have 3 heart stopping moments in the show that I almost cried to. The first moment is when Tom made the video for L after L had that terrible radio experience when she just wanted to talk about her art and they wanted to talk about other things at hand, and that really made me cry. When she cried and when she seen the video and when she cried, that tear came down. I was really like, oh, yeah, because I would like for somebody to make a video for me like that. Like, another hot stopping moment for me is when Nick was missing Charlie when Charlie went to the facility to get better, when they had the Halloween party and Tyle and Nick were sitting down and he just cried. It really showed how their relationship grew a lot during the series, because in the beginning you guys know Tyle did not like Nick at all because he thought Nick was just like the other mean, but when you get to know Nick, yeah, Nick is not like that at all. Nick is so dreamy. That scene was just so, And another hot stopping scene is when Charlie told Nick that he loves him for the first time when he was in the shower, and then when he had to run out with no shoes, no jacket, he just ran with no shoes or nothing and go tell Charlie that he loved him back. And that was just, wow. Ooh, that scene, it really shows that I'd be selling it for less, girl. I'd be selling for less, because I can't even get a man to, it don't even matter what I can't get a man to do right now. I'm talking about Heartstopper. I'm talking about season 3 of Heartstopper. That's all I'm talking about right now. But that is crazy. That is insane. They're in love now. So I'm very excited to see more coming from the show. I'm so mad that it took me literally maybe a day, because I started watching yesterday. I had to sit on my thoughts and stuff because I was just so, it was so amazing. I also like about how they talk about sex in this season.
And I like how they talk about like not knowing what they're doing, because in most TV shows or movies, they just get right into it. But in this, they really show like the immaturity or the amateur, like, you know, in sex, being not able to know what they're doing and being able to speak to your partner and let them know like how you feel and what you need to practice on in the bedroom between your lover. And me being old as I am and still being a virgin, so it really kind of like touched it kind of made me, you know, take a couple of notes from their book and understand what a partner should do when another partner isn't ready or another partner isn't okay with, you know, doing anything yet. In most scenes, I also feel like, you know, I was also scared of them almost getting caught, because it'd be like times where they like kissing in the bedroom. I'm like, girl, you get in. I kind of sort of knew like kissing would eventually start to get boring for them and they would want to do more. And that's just how, you know, the sexual tension grows in a relationship. So I like how they developed that and showed that a lot in this season. Because they was getting it in, girl.
I have a couple of things, jobs of what I should expect for season four. Because season four coming out, right? Season four coming out. I'm ready for season four already. I'm ready for my mics to come back in season four. I know that accent was very terrible. I wanted to see them have a long distance relationship and see how that goes. And I just want to see everybody else grow, you know? I like how Isaac finally told everybody that he was aromantic. He was asexual. And maybe he just, you know, I really experienced what he was going through with the third wheel thing. And I really like, and I had no choice but just deal with it, you know? So I can definitely understand how it took a toll on him and how him and Tao actually got into it. But I was just so glad that they wasn't beefing for like three episodes. They just immediately apologized because L did check Tao, was like, you did the same thing to Charlie when he first was start dating Nick, so don't do the same thing, girl. I really enjoyed that. And yeah, the season was just amazing. It had so many funny moments, so many sweet moments. Ooh, so many sweet moments. Another moment for me is when Mr. Furyk was telling Charlie that he was a wonderful like contender to be the head student, I think that's what it's called. And we seen a younger Mr. Furyk, and it just made me feel sad that he, maybe, you know, if he had a Charlie around, he probably would be, you know, more open. But he will get there dating Mr. He would definitely get there with dating Mr. AJ. You could already see them, like, he's opening up more to him. So I would definitely want to see more of their relationship in season four. Do not stop their relationship in this season, because I want to see more things coming from them. I really stan them so much. But yeah, the season is just amazing. I'm about to watch it again, girl. I've been watching it like six times. That's like one of my comfort shows now. So it's my escape from, you know, everything that, you know, goes on in the real world. So, but comment below your favorite part in season three if you watched it already, because I want to know, because I will actually read and see your favorite parts. Or if you had the same favorite parts I had, I would like to know that too. So that's the end of this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below. And I am out.